Hi, I'm Carmen from Active Galactic Videos, and I'm currently up at Kitt Peak National Observatory, which is in southern Arizona on the land of the Tohono-O'odham Nation. It's the largest collection of research telescopes anywhere in the world. So while we're up here today, let's go check out some of the scopes. The solar telescope opened in 1962. It was then, and still is today, the largest solar telescope anywhere in the world. It has a totally different design from all of the other telescope buildings on the mountain. The rest of the telescopes are in domes because all of those telescopes need to be able to point anywhere in the sky. But the solar telescope was just designed to look at the sun, and the sun follows a path from east to west in the sky every day. So the mirrors just need to be able to look anywhere along this path that goes from east to west in the sky. The angle of the diagonal part of the telescope is 32 degrees. Which is also our latitude here on Kitt Peak. This allows the telescope mirrors to perfectly reflect the sun into the tunnel of the telescope. Building a solar telescope is a little tricky though, right? Because if you're focusing light from the sun, you're also focusing heat from the sun. So if you have a really big telescope focusing heat from the sun, you can imagine you would have a problem, like maybe starting giant fires. That's actually the reason why the diagonal part of the telescope is so long. That's the optical path of the telescope. It's about 200 feet above ground, and then it goes another 300 feet underground. So it's in total 500 feet long. And there's coolant that flows through the whole tunnel so that the image that's produced of the sun is cool enough that it's not starting any fires down in the observation room. The 2.1 meter telescope behind me was the first big telescope on Kitt Peak. Technically, the solar telescope beat it, but the 2.1 meter was the first big telescope on Kitt Peak for nighttime astronomy. So it's been in operation since about 1964, and recently Caltech breathed new life into the 2.1 meter telescope by installing RoboAOKP. So the 2.1 meter telescope will be using adaptive optics, which will effectively make it just as good as any space telescope that doesn't have to look through the Earth's atmosphere. The 3.5 meter telescope is the second largest optical telescope on Kitt Peak, and it's the newest big telescope on Kitt Peak. It was completed in 1994, and the mirror in the 3.5 meter telescope, which is 3.5 meters in diameter, was one of the first mirrors cast at the Stewart Observatory Mirror Lab. So it is actually mostly hollow. They came up with this really ingenious way of making mirrors that allows the mirror to be very lightweight, but still structurally stable. This is the RCT, which stands for a robotically controlled telescope. It was built at a time when astronomers were starting to think that they would be able to put a telescope in space pretty soon, which is a great place to put a telescope because you don't have to look through the atmosphere if your telescope is in space. The atmosphere actually distorts everything that we look at in space. So they needed to build a telescope to use as a test bed for learning to operate telescopes remotely. So this telescope was built to use as a test bed for space astronomy and remote observing, which is a huge part of astronomy today. A lot of astronomers use telescopes remotely. Meet SARA. SARA stands for Southeastern Association for Research in Astronomy. So most of the telescopes on Kitt Peak, including SARA, are actually used by different universities that share the cost of maintaining the telescopes and share the time on the telescopes. So SARA is mostly used by universities in the southeastern US, which is pretty far from Kitt Peak, but Kitt Peak is a really good place to put telescopes, and there aren't as many good locations in the southeastern US. But what makes SARA really possible is that astronomers can use it remotely. So the astronomers who use this telescope don't have to come all the way here to Kitt Peak to use their telescope, which is pretty cool. And more telescopes are made to be used remotely these days. It's very convenient. Most of the telescopes on Kitt Peak are up on this highest ridge, but a few are down on this lower ridge to the southwest. And most of the telescopes on Kitt Peak are optical telescopes, but a couple are radio telescopes, and you can see those down here. We have one radio telescope that's 25 meters in diameter, making it by far the largest telescope on Kitt Peak. Our largest optical telescope is 4 meters in diameter. So the 25 meter VLBA dish that you can see behind me is actually a lot bigger. Next to the 25 meter, we have a 12 meter radio telescope. So that's in the white dome behind me. These telescopes help us learn about the universe just like the optical telescopes, but they're looking at a kind of light that our eyes don't see, but they can see it, and we can learn about the sky by observing this radio light, the same way we can learn about the sky by observing optical light. These are the Space Watch telescopes. The mission of the Space Watch telescopes is to discover asteroids and keep a lookout for any asteroids that might be near-Earth asteroids so that we're aware of them. The 4-meter telescope is the largest optical telescope on Kitt Peak. The mirror inside of it is 4 meters in diameter. When it was completed in the 70s, it was one of the largest telescopes anywhere in the world, but it's not very high on the list anymore because in the last few decades, we've gotten really good at making telescope mirrors, and now we can make big mirrors much bigger than 4 meters in diameter, and we can make them much better than we could at the time that we constructed the 4-meter telescope. Thanks for joining me for this quick mini tour of Kitt Peak. Hopefully we'll make more videos in the future where we can go more in depth about specific telescopes up here. Let us know which telescopes you think are the most interesting in the comments. See you next time. Bye.
Such a surveyor of life forces and their
The cloud starts to collapse, powered only by gravity.